I came across a guy that built a grappling hook by shooting a cannonball with a harpoon. And you know what? I want to build my own. But to be honest with you, I have absolutely no idea how he actually built that. Like, how do you make it so that the cannonball gets shot by the harpoon perfectly? I mean, the concept sounds amazing. But yeah, we're kind of going to have to backwards engineer this thing to actually see if we can make this work, dude. This is going to be absolutely amazing if we figure this out. Now, starting things off, we're actually going to do a little bit of a glitch. So, you know, there's two ways you can do this. You can place one of these in your head. You get it stuck. And then you can place a block on that. But instead, what I'll actually do is I'll use the cake block. And then I'll place a block on top of that. So, yeah, that's just going to give us a bit of an easier surface to actually work on. So that way, you know, we can attach things to our body. It's going to be quite amazing. Now, first things first, I just want to see what happens is, you know, what happens if we actually just place a harpoon and a cannonball right next to each other on our body? Like, is this going to do anything? Okay, so we did something here. All right, now we can walk around again. Okay, dude, we look like an idiot. This is not exactly what his looked like either, so I definitely messed something up. But hey, let's see. We're gonna have to use that, and we... Okay, wait, and we fire it? Oh my god, wait! It actually did something! Wait, the cannonball and harpoon actually got attached. Wait, I actually did not think that was gonna work at all. Okay, we activate them both, and we shoot somewhere, and at some point, they connect? Okay, you know what? That is not working exactly the way I wanted it to. Like, it only kind of worked if I shoot it at like a short distance, like over there. Like at some point they'll connect and then I get a little bit of a boost, but that's not really it, man. Okay, so that's a failure. Now, what if he... Okay, wait. Actually, I have an idea on maybe how he did this. So how about I try that? So I'm actually going to build a bit of a wall in front of myself like this. And this is kind of like where we can actually shoot the grappling hook. This is nothing like what his looked like because, you know, his is all invisible. Now, actually, I don't know exactly if this is how he made it. I'm just speculating here. You know, I'm trying to figure it out as we go. So, okay. So his was not walking this weird starting off. Well, we're just going to ignore that for now. So what if we shoot it like that? Okay, wait, we forgot to make this collision off. Yeah, that all needs to be a collision off. Oops. Okay, let's try that again. Okay, so we're gonna shoot it like bang. Wait. Oh, wait. Did I just create a shield that harpoons can't go through? Yeah, this is like one of those rare glitches that, you know, your harpoon will never actually work. And I just lost the block? Okay, dude, this is weird. What if I make this look more invisible? Yeah, that would have actually worked. Okay, it's the invisibility. It's like weird. It's like a glitch. But yeah, that's actually how you can make like a force field that never allows like stuff to go through it. It's pretty cool. But anyway, that's not what we're trying to make here. We're trying to build an actual, you know, grappling hook. So let's try to work on that instead. Okay, boom. Block back in place. This time around, we're gonna make it like 75% invisible and collision off. All right, let's try that instead. Shkabang! Oh my god, wait! Oh my god, it's totally working! Oh my god! Wait! This is and it's working! Okay, now I should probably attach the lever to my body because now I am currently stuck here. But dude, we just launched ourselves. So the way it works is that pretty much if I shoot my cannonball, like what's the word? Like somewhere on this plane, at some point, the cannonball and the harpoon, they kind of meet like at the same point. And that's like when the two of them get attached. I just died. That was very stupid. I don't know why I thought that was going to work. Holy moly. Now his actually worked a little bit smoother, I think. So I'm going to try to make this thing just actually like cool and sick and nasty, which mine currently isn't. Mine kind of sucks. But hey, we're making progress, man. All right, now we're going to shrink this. We're going to pretty much get to back to where we started. So the guy in the video also used wood. So I'm going to use wood as well. And instead, I'm actually going to like spread this out a little bit more, which I think is what he did. I don't actually know if you're going to have to do this. But actually, you know what? Screw what that guy did. You know what? I'm just going to try to come up with my own design a little bit. You know, I want it to look cool. So one thing that I think would be kind of cool, like, you know, have you seen the anime Chainsaw Man? It's pretty cool. Guy's got like chainsaw for head. I want to have a cannon for head. Oh, wait. We got to anchor things off to start. All right, boom, baby. Now that looks good. You can even see the little Jesse hat. Very nice stuff. And one thing I'm actually curious about is what happens if I place a harpoon and cannonball thing in like the exact same spot? Like, would that also work? So you know what? Let's just try that out next. All right, so I unanchored the whole thing. Now this thing right here is also starting to look a little bit cooler already. I like the vibe this has. Let's see how well it actually, like, works. Like, is this actually going to attach the two together? Oh, my God! Wait, it is! Oh, my God! Wait, but we lost the cannonball. Wait, okay. I think we can actually make this work as well, though. Oh, my God. Dude, this is so cool. Okay, so get rid of that. Sit shit down. Place the cake. Boom. All right, so one problem is that right now the cannonball kind of got, like, disconnected. Now, we can actually fix that. And another thing that I actually want to do... Actually, wait, yeah. I want to make this block here invisible because it looks, like, terrible. So just make that invisible. It just needs to exist there for us to actually, you know, launch this thing. I think we can actually maybe give this, like, a bit of a paint job to make it even cooler. That actually looks bad. Okay, you know what? That doesn't look terrible. You know what? I kind of just wish that I was bigger. So maybe a big candy will fix things. I don't know. I'm just trying things out, okay? Because this right now is looking pretty terrible. Okay, yeah. I think actually when we actually get around to building the final version, we're going to have to build it while in big candy. But for now, we'll just shrink down again. All right, eat that. Bang! Back to normal. Okay, let's just see what happens if we actually turn off aiming. So pretty much when you turn off aiming, rather than it's, you know, just actually just firing off the thing, it will just automatically fire like wherever you're looking. So I think that's what the guy in the video also did. And that right there, that's a bit of a bad place for my lever, actually. I don't want to place it like on my butt. You know what? That actually looks freaking sick. Okay, I wish I was matching those colors. I think I can get that a little closer. You know what? I got those pretty close now. Dude, that looks freaking sick, man. Okay, so I think when I, it did not do anything. Did I break it? Oh, wait, I fired off the thing without the cannonball. Oh, wait, they're not firing at the same angle anymore? Wait, what went wrong? This is the same build. Wait, hold up. What's different now, man? Okay, we completely broke it at some point. I don't know what. Maybe it's the going big? I don't think so, though. Like, literally earlier when we tried this one out, it worked perfectly. Oh, wait. It's because I turned off the free aim mode. I see. So the problem is that they are currently not perfectly lined up and they need to be. But I think I have a solution for that. I think we're going to have to do this every single time actually before we launch, or it's just going to get messed up. But if I place a block right there exactly in front at the exact angle I want to fire at, and actually shrink this down to like absolutely nothing block, like literally like a pixel, just like so. Boom. You see that right there? That's what we're going to have to click. All right, so aim is still turned on. Okay, let's see if this will fix things. So now we'll actually go ahead, place our cake just like before. Actually, I lost my, I still have my paint. Okay, good, good, good. But I lost the position for my thing here. So we're gonna have to replace that right there. Boom. Actually, it's kind of like glitchy right now. I don't know which one I'm clicking all the time. So I'm gonna have to find a different place for it. You know what? I kind of like that spot. That's like pretty good. And yeah, I can always click it. Okay, so that's better. All right, so this time around, what we're gonna do before we launch, we're gonna select everything. We're actually gonna click exactly on that little pop right there. And then we're gonna reset the whole shebang. And then everything just explodes, of course. I forgot to skill this block up. All right, I skilled the block up. I'm gonna make it invisible just so, yeah, nothing gets messed up anymore. Also, guys, if you are using the firework rocket, which you can get by using the code Childrell709 was here, which I've already redeemed, so it's invalid. Anyway, make sure that you actually, with the wrench tool, unlink your firework from the thing. Actually, you know what? I'll just do it just so I can show you guys. So yeah, if I want to use this one, I gotta make sure to go in and actually unlink those two, so that way it doesn't fire off. It will break it. But yeah, we can just hide this and it doesn't matter. All right, let's try it out. Bang! Like right there on that little tiny dot. And now everything should be lined up. When we go unanchored and we walk around and we set everything to aim off. Oh, wait. Why? Why is it not working? Oh, wait, that was it. Oh, it worked. Let's go. Now we can't actually unhook. But anyway, that's amazing. I like that. Dude, this is cool. Yes! It's freaking working! So yeah, you gotta make sure that at some point you line it up so that the cannonball and the grappling hook are like firing at the exact same position. And that's actually where they will like meet up and like freaking do the amazingness. Now, one thing I wanna see is if I can actually make sure to go all the way to the end using this trick. So I'm gonna attach one of these just so that, you know, we can actually hover in place while this thing resets. And let's just see how far we can go, man. Let's see if it's even possible. I use this glitch to maybe like create like an AFK farm or something like that. Like, that could be kind of cool. All right, so we're currently in front of the stage. We're just waiting for our cannonball to be reset. Wait, is it already reset? It already was reset, man. Oh my God. Guys, I would like to be referred to as Chain Ball Man. One thing that I might actually want want to set up. You know what? I'm actually going to set that up while I'm at it. Because currently what happens is after I fire off the cannonball, pretty much we're kind of screwed. Because, yeah, we're waiting for the grappling hook to actually, you know, be reset. So I got to manually reset it every time. But I'm pretty sure I can automate that because math. So pretty much if I go ahead right here, and I can literally place this in my plot. It doesn't even matter. I'm just going to place it like right here. I connect the lever to that and then that to my... Actually, I think I need more delay. That to that. Okay. Let's set it to like 10 seconds total. So like something like that. Something like that. I think that should work. So pretty much after I've launched, it should reset, I think. Yes! Yes, it works! Look, it automatically resets now. Oh my God. How did I like perfectly nail that first try? So yeah, pretty much we launch off the cannon and pretty much by the time that this whole thing like resets, it automatically like retracts the thing. Look, and then... Whoop. Okay, actually, I can lower the time a little bit. But still, that's pretty good. Like 3.2. 3.2 should be fine. All right, let's set off to the end. Let's go. Dude, this is amazing, man. I love this thing. Uh-oh, something got messed up. Something got messed up. Uh-oh. Okay, I messed something up slightly. Now it should be fine, though. So we just... Fire! Woo! Let's go. Dude, you go so far as well. Man, I really like this glitch. This is so sick. Oh, please don't throw a knife at me. I would really appreciate it. If you didn't... Oh, man, dude, this feels so good. Look at these stages, man. It's nice. All right, music stage. Now, this one can actually mess me up pretty good, I think. But I'm just gonna fly through it. Idiot. Now, which stage is this? I don't care anyway. Oh, see, it's the diner stage. Dude, this is a really good looking stage. Water. Get me the heck out of here, man. I don't want to die. And we're already off to the final station. I can't believe it. This is actually a really good way to go to the end. Like, better than you would think it is. Like, this is pretty freaking good. Also, guys, you can do this without the golden harpoon. I know I used the golden harpoon here, but if you just use the regular harpoon, it should be totally fine. I'm pretty sure. Oh, wait, what? Oh, I launched my firework on accident. Oh, my God. Yeah, that's why you want to be careful with the firework, because if you launch the firework, the whole thing will go detached from your body. I accidentally clicked it here. But, dude, we made it to the end, baby. Let's freaking go. Dude, this guy also just claimed it. Please don't slam me, man. I got slammed. All right, there it is. Give me my money. And I guess that's how you build a grappling hook.